Welcome back into the Sports Source. This segment of our program is brought to you by Southeast Termite and Pest Control. Newsflash, we have had a wet and rainy start to summer here in East Tennessee. That means the ground is saturated. That means ants are up on dry land looking for food, looking for a home. Southeast Termite and Pest Control can make sure they don't find their way into your home or office. They have all kinds of treatment plans available. Give them a shout this week or check them out at southeasttermite.com. A good family-owned company, locally owned. Love doing business with these guys myself. Stop the ants before they get into your place of life or business. Southeast Termite and Pest Control. All right, time for my second proposal. This one sounds a little out there, all right? And I can't take full credit. I read this somewhere and loved it. The first time I read it, I thought, well, that's bizarre. That would never happen. Then the more you think about it, you realize that actually takes on every issue I have with the different various types of overtime systems. So let's talk about my goals here. Let's go ahead and put the goals up here. What I wanted to do was take luck out of the equation. So you remove the coin toss element. Two, shorten overtime by making it a sudden death situation, because that's one of the big things. You get now college football is shortening their overtime system a little bit after two because these games are just going on forever. All right, make the idea of sudden death more fair, however. So first team gets the ball, it's just not fair. Okay, how do we address all of that? Let's take a look. Game ends in a tie. Both head coaches walk out to midfield. So let's picture Nick Saban and Dabo Swinney walking out to midfield at the end of regulation, national championship game. The visiting coach, the visiting coach, gets the ball at the 50 to start overtime. Now, the home coach can say, okay, I trust my defense to hold you right here. Or the home coach can bid by saying, we want the ball first, but he has to take it closer to his own goal line. So he says, I'll take it at my 40. And the other guy can say, well, I'll agree with that. Or he'll say, I'm so sure of my offense, I'll take it at my own 30. Okay? So whichever coach agrees to take the ball closest to his own goal line, we'll see his team start with the ball. Then you just play until one team scores, one way or the other. Now, you use five-yard increments to speed up the bidding, so nobody's going to sit there. The 49, 48, 47. The luck of the coin toss is replaced by the decisions of the two coaches. And sudden death is mitigated because to get the ball first, a team must sacrifice field position. I thought this was nuts when I read it. I fell in love with it. I wish they'd do it. I like it. Gentlemen, thoughts, reactions to that plan?
I agree with your first impression.
Well, you like the high school rule that they use now.
I love the college overtime.
It's the high school rule.
No, it's different. I think the NFL is the utterly most unfair overtime of any sport I watch. I think it's ridiculous. But that's
not what we're talking about.
No, I understand that. So I don't like the NFL, and I don't like the sudden death element. I think that each team should get a possession. Okay. That's fair to me. And the NFL overtime is not fair when you don't have a chance to get a possession in certain situations.
And this is bizarre. It will never happen. And whoever came up with this grew up watching Name That Tune or something. I'm already casting my vote negative against.
Well, interesting.
I'm in favor of legalized sports gambling. That's a big topic now. And you get the bidding aspect here, which starts to tap into that. Then that's going to lead fans
to that. You can gamble on who will take the ball.
Yeah, so if the offshore accounts can get some prop bets going really quick, that's something that might tickle a fancy out there. But kind of outrageous, too.
Okay.
So I'm leaning no right now, but I haven't made a final decision.
The reason me and you are smarter than everybody else here. We talked about this on the phone 2 months ago, I think. Yeah. Maybe even
longer
than that.
I've wanted to do this show for 2 months. It's really just to do this plan.
I actually like this a whole lot because you can sit there as a coach, decide my team strength is defense, the Vikings from two seasons ago. So, we'll let you have the ball first. Maybe do a little gamesmanship even, try to get them back. But I'm not a big fan of the high school overtime, the college overtime, but I'm also not a big fan of the NFL overtime either. So to me, this does, at least it gives the teams something we have to think about, something other than heads or tails, or, okay, we go on defense first in college, we go on offense first in college.
Yeah, and the thing is, you take the coin toss out, you also take out it's just the first team to touch the ball because you have sacrificed field position to get the ball. So you're going to be starting from your own 30, 35, and if you don't get your first down, They get the ball in good field position. Okay, I like that. Look, if it were me, the perfect overtime would be the NFL, but the other team gets the ball.
Yeah.
You get a chance to match. If you don't score, it's over. But I like this one for college. I just think it's funky and wanted to put it on TV.
Can you imagine the fan reaction to the head coach's decisions,
exactly.
By the way?
Oh, exactly. That's good for the game. Yeah,
there's rather a lot of strategy. Here's what you do.
It's strategy.
Start it in the XFL. Let them do it, and then let's see how it works.
But the XFL probably won't be around for a year.
So do we need to do the that'd be half a year longer than the AAF.
Yeah, right.
Do we even need to do a vote? This one's three against, so it doesn't even come close to passing.
No, I'll pass it for the phone calls we get Monday for.
I just think it adds an element of if the coaches are making the decision on who gets the ball, I like that.
That is more strategy.
But it's just difficult to pass on first reading.
This would pull out the different personalities of coaches. I mean, just think that meeting at the 50-yard line, Steve Spurrier and Phil Fulmer.
Yeah,
well, they do.
That would be fascinating.
You think there's going to be a little bit of one guy's going to sit there, I'll take it inside my own end zone, go ahead and give our team the ball. Yeah. Another guy might be a little nervous.
All right, so that one got nuked. We'll see what they think about my next one, which is how to create a national holiday for college football. If we're talking about fixing college football, how about like creating a Selection Monday to match basketball Selection Sunday? I'll describe that and they can poo-poo it next. Come on back on the Sports Source.